Over now to the West Philippine Sea issue, the outgoing Chief of Staff of the Armed Forces of the Philippines says the leadership change in the military was triggered by the need to focus more on protecting Philippine waters. General Andres Centino is set to take on a new role as a presidential advisor on the West Philippine Sea. He aims to formulate a new strategy in dealing with maritime tensions with China.
Our leadership has deemed it important na mabigyan ng focus and importance yung the way we address the issues there in a bigger scale. And that's why they thought of creating an office of the presidential advisor. It will be a combination or a mix of everything that we can do. It doesn't have to be military alone. It has to be a combination of efforts. That's why the task force would most likely be interagency, meaning there will be inclusion among other agencies to compose the task force.
Manila's top defense official, eager to know details of the meeting between former Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte and Chinese leader Xi Jinping. See, the Philippine government is still clueless over what was discussed when Duterte met with Xi in Beijing earlier this week. But Defense Secretary Gbo Chutoro believes Duterte had the best interests of the Philippines in mind when he spoke with Xi. He adds he can't judge yet if the meeting should be of a cause of concern.
We'd like to wait as to what was the outcome of such a meeting. And we encourage all efforts anyway to engage with China on a track, a non-formal track. However, from where I sit, my position is to build a credible deterrent. Pero inaasahan natin dating presidente ng Pilipinas, si Presidente Duterte. At inaasahan din natin na ang interest ng Pilipinas ay nasa ay taglay niya.
An expert meanwhile says Duterte's visit may be aimed at reassuring Beijing that the Philippines remains an ally to China.
Normally, a current leader of China does not meet a former president or prime minister of another country. I can't see any precedent on that. Therefore, I would look at Duterte's visit as very important. One, number two, as some kind of an appeasement or bearing ties between China and the Philippines as a result of this increasing, deepening defense alliance between the Philippines and the U.S.
Manila's Defense Secretary also says the Philippines is keeping a close eye on Taiwan amid the threat of an invasion from China. Secretary Chudoro says government is preparing contingencies related to that possibility, as well as other conflicts in the region.
First and foremost, we really have to make an assessment whether such is likely or not. Nonetheless, we continue to plan on all contingencies, not merely any flashpoint between China and Taiwan, but any contingency within the theater. And it's a multi-agency effort, not only the defense effort. That is a thing that we continue to monitor daily. And hopefully the engagements bilaterally between the United States and China leads to a diffusion of tensions in that theater.
China has been claiming Taiwan as its own territory, despite the island's strong objections. It has increasingly entered Taiwan's airspace in recent years and has exerted pressure on countries to sever ties with the island. China has never renounced the use of force to bring Taiwan under its control. Turning now to the International Criminal Court's drug war probe, the Philippines ends its engagement with the ICC after the appeals chamber junked Manila's plea to end its investigation into alleged crimes against humanity committed in the Duterte administration's bloody war on drugs. Solicitor General Menardo Guevara said he discussed the matter with President Marcos, who agreed the Philippines will no longer engage with the ICC. He notes, though, government nearly won, with the appeals chamber voting 3-2 to continue with the probe. Families of drug war victims, meanwhile, are bent on cooperating with the ICC's probe. Among them, the uncle of 17-year-old Kian de los Santos, whose death in the hands of the police in 2017 led to a temporary halt in Duterte's drug war. Now, three cops were convicted in November 2018 for his murder.
Nakahanda ako na ikwento sa kanila kung ano yung nangyari. Wala nung day one hanggang sa promulgation. At handa din naman akong makipagtulungan sa kanila. Ipakita yung mga nakita pa namin ebidensya dun sa katawan ni Kena.
A petition is filed to eject Philippine police from the offshore gaming hub they raided in the Metro Manila city of Las Piñas. The petition was filed by a lawyer representing five Chinese nationals who were tagged as the hub's operators. It accused the police of refusing to vacate the area despite the expiration of their search warrant. Attorney Christian Vargas claims the police are using the private property as a detention and holding facility. The police raided the hub in June and detained over 2,000 workers.
This is a blatant violation of the right of a citizen or a person, no, under our constitution, to not only to liberty, but to property. Insofar as my client is concerned, their damage cannot be quantified because of these acts, no. It's irreparable.
Economic recovery and poverty alleviation remains as the Marcos administration's priorities a year after the president took his oath. But priority measures meant to address these issues are yet to hurdle the Congress Senate. RG Cruz with this special report.
This is Norma Abacan. She's on her way to a local fishmonger to get their meal for the day. She's going to split her purchase with her husband, a freelance driver. They live just steps away from the seat of the country's House of Representatives, where President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. is set to deliver his second State of the Nation address. Norma sells beauty products to augment her husband's income so they can cope with inflation.
Sa ngayon, racket, direct selling. Hindi po nag-aalok.
Nag-aalok na parang face to face?
Apo, parang personal collection. Mas po, yung bigas po. Tsaka yung isda, lahat naman po tumaas, kaya lang sana mapababa.
Controlling inflation remains the top national concern of a majority of Filipinos according to Pulse Asia's latest survey. It's also the one issue where the respondents said the Marcos administration fared most poorly.
Doon sa increase ng paid ng workers, doon sa dalawa pang usapin, lalo na yung pinakamahalaga, yung mataas na presyo ng bilihin, hati ang Pilipino, one-third ang approving, one-third ang undecided, at higit sa one-third ang disapproving. So ibig sabihin, karamihan ng mga Pilipino ay parang hindi sila nasisiyahan doon sa, o aprobado doon sa pagtugon ng administrasyon sa dalawang usapin na ito, kahirapan at mataas na presyo ng bilihin.
Senate President Miguel Zubiri says the economy and uplifting the lives of the impoverished remain the priorities of the administration, as seen in the 20 priority bills targeted for enactment by both the House and the Senate by year-end. Most of the bills have already hurdled the House but are languishing in the Senate.
It's almost about 44 measures. Pero yung pinangako namin na may pasa namin hopefully by December of 2023 is about 20. Sayang momentum natin. This year, 2022 to 2023, we're looking at 6.5 growth, GDP growth rate. Ang gusto po natin Pangulo by middle of his term, by 2025, baka makaabot na tayo ng 8% growth rate, which I think is phenomenal. So, phenomenal sa buong region. Talaga magaling yan. Magandang numero yan. Tayo siguro ang pinaka-darling pagdating sa GDP growth rate sa ating region, Southeast Asia. So kailangan...
Before the 19th Congress adjourned its first regular session last June, only six out of the then 42 priority bills got the nod of the country's bicameral legislature. The Senate chief believes most of his colleagues will vote for the unfinished priorities.
Meron lang may kukonta na mas na, nakikita ko na medyo substantial would probably be the mandatory ROTC kasi meron din from the majority na ayaw. The others, I presume that they are happy bills. Even the MUP, you know, yung ating pension ng ating mga sundalo at kapulisan, maduguyan. I feel that within the Senate itself, we can get the majority support of that. Kasi long-term, pag tinignan mo yung long-term situation, lalong lalala ang ating fiscal position pag hindi po natin na-actionan yan. Dahil as of today, yung buwis, binabayaran mong buwis, binabayaran kong buwis, at lahat ng mga kababayan natin, yun pong ginagamit natin para sa pensyon ng sundalo at kapulisan. May mga madugo, pero sa tingin ko papasa din.
Senate President Pro Tempore Loren Legarda, however, explains the process won't be simple and it will depend on many factors.
Legislating any measure is a complex, arduous process that involves consultations, negotiations, sometimes even compromises. The extent to which these bills will be easy or difficult to enact will depend on many factors, like the level of support and cooperation from not just the Senate, but both chambers of Congress, even the alignment of interests and advocacies among lawmakers, and the overall political climate.
A protracted debate is also inevitable.
Differing opinions and finding a common ground is essential in advancing the president's agenda and achieving meaningful results.
A political expert, however, says beyond working on unfinished priorities, the administration must also zero in on making sure the country's national budget is properly spent, as this is key to making sure all programs are implemented well.
Sabi na rin yan, pero I would argue na kailangan ng more effective governance mechanisms. Aside from the budget modernization, hindi natututukan yung performance. Kailangan din palakasin yung congressional oversight. During budget implementation. After all, sila yung nag-approve ng budget. Having said that, baka kailangan rin magkaroon ng congressional voice at the very start of the budget process.
Dr. Magno also says the public must have a greater voice in crafting the budget and the government must employ new and emerging technologies such as artificial intelligence to improve the delivery of government services. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.
Various groups set to hold protests during Monday's SONA. On one side are progressive groups slamming Marcos for failing to address issues including corruption, low wages, and unemployment.
Ang gusto po nating irehistro yung suporta natin sa panawagan ng mga manggagawa para sa pagtaas ng sahod. At syempre, magbigay ng hatol sa one-year presidency ni Bongbong Marcos.
On the other hand, pro-Marcos supporters will also hold demonstrations. Any show of support for the Philippine president. The Philippine police, meanwhile, are calling on protesters to maintain order.
I'm appealing to our fellow Filipinos who will be doing these rallies to make sure na sana naman ay in the exercise of their rights, huwag naman maapakan yung karapatan ng ibang tao, pati na rin kasama na rin yung kapulisan natin.
The PNP says it's entirely ready for the president's SONA, but it warns the police are geared for worst-case scenarios, including possible arrests of protesters.